have this very old soldering iron, which was made in South Africa. Interesting, it's still got the price on it. This is a very old price. Old labels stuck on the plug. This is credit or credit, 50 rand obviously, and contant or cash, 45. So basically, you used to get a 10% discount if you paid it for straight. Not sure what the LID is for the top there. It's a WP Western Province, if I had to take a guess. Ace to Vada. Vada ware and Aster iron. So probably hardware or ironware. Oh, even the plug was made in South Africa. Made in RSA. Anyway, the only problem is it doesn't really seem to be very hot. Plug it in. And check it with the temperature. I mean, it's slowly getting somewhere hot. Anyway, so if it's topping out around 50, it's not going to do a very good job of soldering. So let's open it up and figure out what's wrong with it and try and fix it. A couple of screws. Bits of ceramic insulation being broken here. Maybe they've been squashed. Okay, ooh, well, that's not good, is it? The red wire is rather loose. Let's sort that out. Just add a little bit of solder to that wire to get it to be a little bit more robust, because yeah, I think that'll do. Quite the fiddly business. Yeah, I don't understand why this has not become a popular way of doing this. There we go, let's try it again. Well, it's getting a little hotter than it was before. Interesting enough to check over here. So far we've doubled it up, it's about 100. Yeah. 150, 160. Now it's getting going. I'd say 200 is a lot hotter than 50. Comparing it to the more modern set of, what's it currently saying, 160, 70, 80, 230. The built-in temperature from the more up-to-date soldering iron. It's saying 260, whatever, 260 odd at the moment, and falling. 250. Push that up a bit. 350. There we go, 260 versus 240, 270 versus 260. Well, from the plus side, we'll definitely melt solder now. Make smoke. Okay, so all back together and obviously working. Even if the multimeter underreads a bit, which I think it does, the soldering iron still takes a very long time to heat up, and as a result, you know, it's probably best suited to a backup and perhaps for abusing rather than actual soldering. So when I melt plastic together or burn something into wood, then use this one and rather keep the good soldering iron for soldering electronics and electrical equipment. But yeah, quick fix, on to the next thing.